adore your enemies, to your diseases, to your financial lack, to your depression that come against you, they are confounded. They are brought to shame.
Those things matter. All the powers of darkness, they all sleep, they are confounded. When all they know, you confess, I am the righteousness of God in Christ.
It was like a voice from heaven encouraging his birth. Don't think you're the only one. The man after my heart, David, he confessed my righteousness all day long. And when you do it, your enemies are confounded. Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Dear friends, as we celebrate Christmas this month, Wendy and I pray that you experience the Lord's love like never before. Christmas is all about Jesus, about the amazing, great, and abundant life He came to give you. This month, I'm making my own Grace Revolution now available to you for a gift of any amount.
It's our way of saying thank you for helping us spread the gospel of grace around the world. We love you and we believe this resource will bless you and anyone you give it to. We want you to experience the life-changing grace of our Lord Jesus in every area and a personal grace revolution.
That's right. The power to grow is all so many people free and help us make others understand and share the gospel. That's why we are offering a free gift of any amount this month, because we know you'll be a personal blessing. So do request this great resource for yourself or as a gift for your loved ones this holiday season. That's a wonderful and great present.
The preceding paid program was
even turn the part over to you. Only eternity is going to reveal heaven. Millions of people have come to know Jesus Christ through your soul. A Christian television special, the Great Trinity Broadcasting Network. Guess what has happened? December 17th, 8 p.m. Hardly more than he has.
First we're doing.
Yep, it's going to be awesome. Y'all join us. Why is this so many great songs? Why? Charles Phillips
that God has to have in existence for
have to be thought about. It doesn't have to be forced. It doesn't have to be
conflicted. I don't know where he put it, but yeah.
Okay, we're going to preach this. Hold on, I'm coming at you. Hold on, man. So, when you talk about culture, honor is something that should come naturally. Honor is when you have the ability to look past the dirt and see great. And you continually place value on them because of the great, understanding that the dirt comes with it. So we know that God's kingdom is like a treasure in a field. Great strength is always accompanied by not so great strength.
Thank you.
Why is that? Why is that? Great husbands are always accompanied by husbands. They clip their toenails and just let them fly into the carpet. Those of you that are engaged, yes, it is a fact. Just hold on, Mike. Just hold on. There are great things about every person in here. And we want to turn the great button up when we come to church. And when we leave and go home, the great button. The great button gets flipped. And it's just back to John and Sarah and the Lord. I mean, we don't know who we are. What is a field? A field is dirt. And Jesus said, when you find greatness in somebody, it's so fast. You take the whole person and understand that there are personality quirks in there, of things that annoy, there's things that we don't particularly like, and there are characteristics that may not be attractive to us.
And honor what you
are in, if you're going to extract the treasure.
Yes, not 445 yet.
Oh,
I've been talking about. Hey, put number six back up on screen if you would, and just leave it up there for a minute, because I've only referred to it several times. The Lord, somebody say the Lord. God, he's speaking. He's about to. So God's going to speak to Moses. Okay, keep reading. Next verse. Speak to who? Aaron. Aaron's got two names. I like Aaron. Hallelujah. Aaron and his son. Say, this is the way you shall bless who? Say to them, next verse. The Lord bless you, keep you. Make his face shine upon you, be gracious to you. The Lord lift his countenance upon you, and the Lord give you peace. Last verse. So they shall put my name on the children of Israel, and I will bless them. So God said, if Israel is going to get my blessing, and Israel put my name on heaven. How many of you all know that God is so branded you and so got you that he is identified with you and you with him forever? And he has put his name on you. So I tell you that, but I got his name on me. He's got his name on me. You know Moses? Moses, he told Aaron and his sons to turn around and tell Israel, and after you bless them, you put my name on them, and I will bless them. So God has to talk to Moses. Aaron has to listen to Moses. The children of Israel have to listen to Aaron. So God's blessing is only going to get here if they receive him. Here's the problem. The last time they heard from Aaron, raised up an idol, and in the first moment of Moses'
rumbling as on dark land.
Jesus, throwing instead of throwing air on a wave.
Any sense of our traces, let's try this again. And see if this time you can't go out there and represent me like you got some sense. And the people of Israel got the blessing of the Lord. Because they were willing to honor the vessel through which God said, although his mistake was public in front of everybody. Moses was not, Aaron was not honorable. They had to honor him despite his conduct, behavior, and extremely poor leadership. I'm not talking about he had a bad day or made a couple of bad decisions. I'm talking about he led an entire nation into false worship. Moments after God had just struck Pharaoh's military army and thrust him out with a mighty hand. I can't hear God, but reject the one he sent. Two people sitting on both sides of you have made numerous mistakes. And while you're wondering what mistakes they made in their life, this is their wonderful mistakes you made. Lots of altar calls, especially during the worship. I love to see God touch his people. But the fact is, I don't want to raise up a church where I'm trained and I got to touch you. Because that's not true. God will not allow his church to be personality driven. This is not about a person on the stage. A powerful church is a church where you can heal people. Through 13:8, see something, and you don't even know it, but you make your name fall. There's a treasure involved. And he looks just like a normal guy. But God lives in Bob. And sometimes when I do little things, I grab somebody's hand and you're not being ugly, but you just place no value on the moment you're around. It's a very embracing thing. Not understanding that it was that touch that God wanted anointing to flow through that touch. Diabetes can be destroyed and a tumor can shrink, not because you made it to the stage, but because you grabbed Bob's hand. That's a particular church I want to go to. I don't want to go to church where the guy on the stage is the only one with power. I don't want to go to church where the guy on the stage is the only one that can pray for me. I want to go to church where everybody in the whole place is bowed back full of the Holy Spirit, and all you got to do is honor him correctly, and all of a sudden the treasure jumps out of him and begins to jump on you. Anything can happen. There's anybody in the building, but all there is to wait. Would you do me a favor all over the building from the back side to side? Can I have everybody stand up with me at the same time, please? Jesus came to be sinned. When Jesus died, and I accepted him as my Savior, my sin died with him. And the Bible says that the Holy Spirit, God, now lives on the inside of me. Wow. Now I'm never alone. And maybe I do have broken places, but now I don't have to face them by myself. And maybe I do have some stuff that just seems like it's really hard for me to get it right. But I have help. The Bible even says, in my weakness, he's strong.
God comes and lives inside of me, he's not repelled by my weaknesses, but he runs toward them. Can you imagine that? The very areas of my life that I'm on the way to see Jesus runs straight at them? Why? Because he don't want you to be weak forever. And it's in your weakness he shows up. Your weaknesses are God's opportunities. And I don't want anybody to leave this building or shut off their smartphone or computer today and be on your own to fight your weaknesses and your broken places all by yourself. I got a God who lives inside of me, and when I screw up, he says, get up, Ron, now let's try this again. His mercies are new every morning. And if I screw up tomorrow, Tuesday's a brand new day. And if I screw up Tuesday, God makes me up with you. It's a brand new day. Would you bow your head and close your eyes for just a moment and peer in the air? Say what, I've never accepted Jesus. I've never really prayed that prayer. That's come into my heart. But I got a lot of weak places. I got a lot of broken things. I got a lot of areas of my life that don't act right. And a God that will come live in me anyway. And run my word up and help me with them. This sounds like water in my soul. If you're in this place and you don't know Jesus, if you want to make sure before you leave today, you made this decision and you know that before you leave, Jesus Christ lives on the inside of you, and you're going to leave this place with that treasure. If you want to know that you know that you know, right now in the quietness of this moment, be you and God. Without shame or without hesitation, just keep your hand in the air. So I want to know that you're right there. Yeah, hands going everywhere. Yes. 35 hands probably just went up, and I can't even see it through the balcony. Hallelujah. Hands went up. We have more hands going through the first service. I didn't count them, but they probably than I've ever seen. Would you grab the hand of a neighbor? There's a treasure in that hand. There's a treasure in that hand. If it's your wife, you might be mad at her, but there's a treasure in that hand. Now let's pray this prayer together, because I don't want anybody to get saved by themselves. It's in the family. Say, I thank you, Jesus, that you're a God that's not afraid of my broken places or my weaknesses. I'm asking you to come into my heart. I believe that you died and rose again so that I could be saved. Wash my heart. Cleanse me of all my sins. Come live in me and be my Lord and Savior. From this moment forward, I thank you that now and forever, I am saved. Put your hands together the loudest you have all day. I got 30 or 35 people just accepted Jesus.
Jesus gives you what he is, and remember, his holiday season, make peace.
vision takes two things to take people, great people, and great resources. For vision to come to pass, nobody can ever do it alone. Nobody can ever do it without something, without resources. You better want to know. You have to come along beside us. Come along beside us. We're saying, we're trying to say
challenging message with love,
Covenant. Thank you, man. Thank you, guys.
up on prices for it.
Why?
What's the reason for it? It's so rich in revelation. It's so rich in understanding why. God sent his own begotten son. So that me and you could become sons and daughters. He sent Jesus to win some opponent of the fact. Like I didn't say, Elijah, he better than all of the good Christians. But the fact is, Jesus Christ, the whole son, that is the whole reason.
Even the king of the Jews, Herod, didn't know what all the people
Sure. You're gonna go sideways, head over here. Yeah, with the not a bad thing. That's a good thing. Just like I had the Lord wake me up in the middle of the night and I say,
call 800 B 0 560.
I just like.